Hi, this is Bruce Bishop for ChronicleT.com. We're back yet again with Tim Alcorn from AM 930 WEOL. How you doing, Tim?
I'm doing well. It's great to be here at Smitty's, although we are in a new location as far as our Smitty's shoot is concerned. Now, for the past several weeks, we've been at the exact same table, in the exact same chairs. What happens when we show up today, Bruce?
People are eating.
Yeah, someone's in our table
the
and chair.
The nerve of them.
I feel like, was it Goldilocks?
Right. You know what we should do is we should have names on our chairs like the one that you happen to be sitting in.
Yes. Now, for those who have never been to Smitty's, and this is not a political show, we take no stances, we take no positions, but Smitty's is very famous for the fact that several years ago, President Barack Obama came here for lunch, and there's pictures in Smitty's and so forth, and they actually have his chair gold-plated. And so what does Bruce tell me to do today? He tells me to sit in the president's chair. I'm not in the Oval Office. I'm not in the West Wing. But I'm in the chair,
you
Bruce.
You got the president's chair, and that's all that matters, which is going to make this video so much better than all the rest.
Oh, yeah. This will be a real keeper.
This is the one you want. This is the one you want to
Elkhorn
watch.
Elkhorn sitting in Obama's chair.
That's right.
It's the only time I want to sit in that chair, by
that's
the
right.
way.
That's right. It's probably best. Trust me.
The president's chair, I mean. Not this one particularly.
You're just going downhill fast. We should probably just get going.
Let's talk high school football.
Let's talk about something that won't get you in trouble. High school football last week. Some important games. Why don't you just kind of catch us up?
There were some important games for Lorain High. They had a big game on the road over at Maple Heights. They got a phenomenal performance from their running back, Carlos Chavis. Did an outstanding job, scored 3 touchdowns, and their defense played very, very well. They held a Maple Heights offense that had been putting up big yardage throughout the year to under 200 yards in that game. So a big win for Lorain High, and that sets up a monumental game for the Titans this Friday. They'll be home to Bedford. We'll talk about that game a little bit later on. But, boy, Dave McFarland has that team playing very, very well. They've won 6 in a row. They're now 6-2 on the year, so hats off to the Titans. Boy, another big game last Friday night, Bruce. The fact that Avon Lake went over to Olmsted Falls and the Bulldogs, if you recall, 2 weeks ago, they lost in the final minute to Midview. Midview kind of kept them out of the end zone on a goal line stand in the final couple of minutes. Boy, the identical scenario last Friday night. Once again, Olmsted Falls has the ball in the final minute of play. This time they're able to score, and then they go for two. They go for two against Avon Lake and convert the two-point conversion. Their outstanding quarterback, Hutke, he ran it in for the two-point conversion, and they beat Avon Lake by 1 point. So a thrilling win for the Bulldogs last Friday night. That puts Avon Lake in a tough spot now. That's a tough loss for them, and they play Midview this Friday night. We've got that game on WEOL or on WEOL.com, depending upon if the Indians are playing on Friday night. But that's a real, real difficult setback for the Shoremen. We'll see if they can bounce back. And, hey, hats off to two teams that won last Friday night, and in doing so, clinched their playoff spot. The Midview Middies with a big win, another huge performance from their great quarterback, Dustin Crum. They knocked off Lakewood in pretty convincing fashion. So Midview has now guaranteed themselves a playoff berth in Week 11, and so have the Avon Eagles. Boy, Avon just keeps putting together great wins after great wins. They went over to Amherst last Friday night and beat a pretty competitive Amherst Comet squad. The score wasn't indicative of really how well Amherst played and how well they battled this Avon team, but a great job by Mike Elder.